We don't want to admit to ourselves that we have that much power sometimes.
It's crazy, man.
That we have that much effect on what happens in our lives. And we really do. It's crazy. There's a book that has changed my life called The Tools by Barry Michels and Phil Stutz. And it basically, they're two, therapists who struggle. One of them was a mentee to the other. I forget who was, which was which, but basically was taught a set of tools for people to actually use, because a lot of their patients would come to them with a problem and they'd say, oh, well, this is why you're having that problem. And they would explain, you know, oh, you have a trauma from your past that keeps making you have these thoughts or making you act in this way. And some of the patients were like, this isn't okay. So what do I do? What can I do? And they're like, well, you just have to try to stop, or like, you know, something that doesn't give them an actual thing to do, practice, to help them. And this book gives you tools. It gives you things to actually say, do, visualize, think in the moment when you're having a doubt, or when you there's something you know you should do and you're in your head, basically to get out of your head is what it is, and get into flow. So this is why I bring it up. So like for me, I've always had that moment where I was like, what does it take to be, you know, to separate yourself and be successful? And a lot of this comes from my dad, and his, you know, days wrestling and everything. And he's just the most disciplined, self-disciplined human being I know. He was in high school. After his sophomore year, he literally decided, I'm never going to lose a match again. Went on, and it's not like just say it and then do the same thing. You got to change, right? He would practice every single day, shoot whatever, 100 double legs in his garage on a wrestling dummy, you know, say no thanks to the friends, to go into the beach. I got to get my stuff in. I'll meet you guys there. I got to get the work in first. Work. And he had this in his mind all the time. And as I'm sure there were days for him where, you know, that thought crept in his mind, like, I don't want to do this today. But it was a matter of using one of the tools. He doesn't know about the tools or anything. I talked to him about it. But for me, what I'm getting at telling that story is I would have those same moments in high school where I knew I would have to work, or I knew I would have to go work out or get up early or do something. And in my mind, you just have that voice. It's like, I can just do it like in a little bit, or I can do it tomorrow. And for me, it was like, I finally found something to get myself to do those things. And I would literally just tell myself, do what you don't want to do. Do what you don't want to do. And then you'll be successful. Do what you don't want to do. And so that would get me up out of my chair, and I'd just do what I didn't want to do. And I'd go and I'd work out, have a great workout, whatever, boom, there's the rest of your day. And this puts this into a more kind of focused way of using that as a tool. For me, that worked for a while, but this was it's called the reversal of desire. Sorry, I'm rambling.
No, go.
Basically, when you encounter something that you don't want to do, the chances of you doing it, say I need to go work out, and I wake up in the morning, I'm like, I don't want to work out. Well, if I can convince myself that I do want to work out, reversal of desire, just by saying it out loud, then I'll be able to, you know, the chances of me actually going to work out will skyrocket, okay? So it talks about the physical pain. You can literally feel physical pain. If you have social anxiety, it's physically painful to go break out and talk to people. And so the phrase is, I love pain. And I sound like a crazy, it sounds like a masochist thing, right? But convincing yourself that you love being uncomfortable is the thing. So that's what really pushes you past growth. So that's what I felt in that moment, playing against Oregon, flipping tune. I love pain is what I really, in essence, was feeling when I just made that decision to go. And that translates actually into the music thing, which we'll get into in a little bit.